G'day everybody, welcome to Distant Date Night, live from Canlow. I'll put the countdown on this.
Comment?
Just a little comment.
Okay. Taking your time.
Hello, can you hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Woohoo! All right, yes. G'day everybody. Welcome to Distant Date Night. So I was just mouthing at the computer before then, and I'm from Canlow to the world and introducing the Ocelots. I was looking at it going, random. I'm not muted. and nobody even saw me running around like a headless chook just before, so you know it's even funnier.
We all have our introverted moments.
How are you guys?
We're great. We're in good form. It's a Saturday morning here, so we're still fresh and out of the womb of the morning. Yeah, we're doing great.
The fog has cleared. It was the foggiest day. Usually when fog comes, it kind of disperses during the... But this...
There was
so much fog throughout the whole day. It was like there was something happening in here.
Oh, that's nice. Did you write a song about it?
Not yet.
No.
But the last time there was a fog, there was at least 6 songs.
Yeah.
That's what happens, you see. Nice. Where are you, by the way?
Opportunity.
I missed. whereabouts are you now?
We're in the land of crappy jokes. In Leipzig.
Leipzig, one of my favorite places. Yeah, cool.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a very cool, it's a cool city. And we've lived here for around 2 years now.
Cool.
Becoming more German as the days come on. Mm-hmm. More organized, hopefully. And more.
I love the markets there. I like it's one of my favorite markets. Although if he's all becoming really hip, he's probably all go there now. Whereas when I went there, 10 years ago, there was so much awesome treasure.
Yeah,
the flea markets are pretty, they're still pretty raw at the moment. Like, they're still very authentic, like angry East Germans that just, that they're so cool because they just hate everybody and always have.
Awesome.
And they're so disappointed to sell you their stuff. They're just like, take it. It's a great culture, but the flea markets are cool.
I like you kind of like you scrape through like rotten like the, you find this stuff and it's like underneath, like dirt and metal, and you keep scraping through until you find like this stuff at the bottom, like a badge, a brooch or something. And you think, I found the best treasure in the whole world, nipping it back, and Oh, that's what I think of Leipzig markets. I got the best pair of Doc Martens there, the genuine proper Doc Martens that had definitely been on some adventures. Well, I'll play a song to you. I'll play a song just to warm the crowd up, and I'll come back to you. I thought
Did you
I'll
write any play songs in the Doc Martens?
I probably did, because they're like a maroon Doc, and I definitely wore that on a couple of, I wore them on a couple of tours, so there's got to have they surely have had songs come out of them.
Or do you specifically take your shoes off when you're writing songs?
Well, no, because I actually have a pair of slippers that I bought in the shop that Leonard Cohen bought his slippers from, and I put the slippers on and I write songs in my Leonard Cohen slippers.
I have a great, like, these are the best songwriter tool that you can have.
Oh, yeah, Crocs. Yeah. Do you get Aussie songs out of that? If you get cranky, you can throw your Crocs across the room without really breaking anything.
All
I'll go and play a song and I'll see you in a second. All right. These are all like, you've had 15 cups of coffee, you're all like, all ready to rock. Okay. I'll play a song called Midnight Mermaid Blue, which I wrote recently. So cool. All right. See you in a second.
See you soon.
Okay. All right. Okay, fix the hair before I have to look at myself singing. Okay. Dark night, how do I honor you? Star so bright, whisper moon. Drove home with the sky lit by jewels. Sea green, variations on the theme. And I'm catching treasures of the deep, deep inside of me. Give me a light, I'll go fishing. What's beneath, what's unseen? From this perspective, everything is shimmering. Sunlight on my skin, shade too lingering. Midnight mermaid blue, shine like a mirror on the earth. Change my point of view. Teach me how to live this lovely life. Dark night, how do I honor you? Star so bright, whisper me. Drove home slowly, feeling that you know me. Sky still, weather calm, everything in your arm. Midnight mermaid blue, shine like a mirror on the Change my point of view. Teach me how to live this lovely life. Midnight mermaid blue, shine like a mirror on the earth. Change my point of view. Teach me how to live this lovely life. Orion and the sea, listen to Yay, cool. I wrote that like, pardon?
That's your song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As I was singing it, I was thinking, oh, wouldn't it be nice if the Ocelots sang harmonies on it?
Well, you know.
That'd be cool.
There's always Ocelots for hire for background.
I was thinking, like, you know, we talked about Cohen before. Like, Cohen also always had, like, you know, the best people putting extra sprinkles on the song. So, you know, I was thinking in that kind of way. There's lovely. Anyway, that was just as what I was thinking as I was singing the song. Yeah. We can't sing together with all this long distance stuff, but we can play each other's songs, which is good.
Yeah. But I'm sure some jazz expert will be able to, like, mathematically think of the delay and then play along to someone so that it's in sync, you know?
Like, no I'm way. Sure. You're right. They could too. They well, would I'm, just we're not be. They would. Yet. There would so be that exact person, the complete nerd who would completely get it right on point, or at least like jazz enough to be on point, you know. Oh, what are you going to play us this morning?
We're going to start off with a slow version of a fast song, actually, to be more specific, a slow version of a loud song.
Yeah. We do this.
We don't slow down the tempo. We just do a quieter version. It's
cool.
We're like those like advertisement piano version of
the soft female voice singing Pixie songs. You know.
You're going for some elevator music this morning, right?
Yeah. Yeah. So this song actually is about going on the Nullarbor.
Oh, cool.
From east to west in Australia. And, well, it's about a few things, but it kind of came out of that because we met this crazy farmer dude that he was telling this crazy story about how all of these wild dogs ate all of the sheep. And he was like, those were wild dogs. Those were like,
they weren't wild dogs. They were dingoes.
They were wild dogs. Yeah. Like he was super drunk and he just said it a million times and then we were like, there was something in that. So yeah.
Perfect. Cool. Thank you.
My shadow makes footprints. In the path, and I saw them on my way over the clouds, going out to face the flame, ear out right down the stairs, not too far. Step down, and it took boat on a dune won't save you, and a sunstroke in the sun won't burn you. World this forest, fire you and me. We're the difference between wild dogs and coyotes.
That little tiny bit of echo there as I change over. That's beautiful. Wow, it's cool. It doesn't sound like that old farmer carrying on. you didn't put any like Aussie slang in there. I mean, like, maybe I might have missed one, but yeah, you've got a few fans here. You've got Corey's joined in and says, "Yous are so cute and gorgeous voices." And Alona. G'day, Alona. And
hello,
Kayleen loves the sound of the banjo. And Julie Melia.
Hello, Julie.
Yeah, Julie, yeah. You always forgot me yesterday.
Yeah, we know.
God, yeah, technology's so crazy. You can just I'd love if someone heckled as a comment so that and then you can just
I can bring it up in the middle of
only bring up the bad comments, you know, so it's kind of like calling people out, you know.
I'll try and put here. So Ruth Hazelton popped in there. I'm just giving you a little bit of a round of applause after your song, right? Okay. And here we go. Julie says, you played the world premiere of your song, The Switch, on her radio show in Melbourne 2020. There you go.
Crazy. What a lifetime.
Nervous.
We're old and withered now. Yeah.
Claire joined in there. Cool. There's the crew. The whole crew's tuned in. like, nice to see everybody hanging out, and thanks for all your comments. And you know, you can probably be cheeky with us, we won't mind, hey, if they send us funny comments. Maybe not in the middle of the song though, because I have this bad habit in the middle of a song of looking at the comments, and then I get distracted and then I forget the lyrics, so
we just need to say things to annoy the Australian audience, like what's the best part of Australia, like New Zealand.
Yeah, then they'll turn it off. you want them to get all smarty pants. Like,
cut. Yeah.
They'll get more smarty pants. The more you poke them, you see, they kind of like
We want to be trashed. We want it like boo. Yeah.
I need to
ground yourself, I think.
Well, the Australian audiences are renowned as. Some of the toughest in the world, and I remember, because like you turn up at your gig and there's like four drunks at the back of the pub and you're like, oh my gosh, and me sing, you know, like both of us singing, you know, sweet songs, you know, we're not sort of smashing it out or anything, but you got to toughen up and just get good at throwing it out there. I had an American come on tour with me once, and he was so shocked at the audiences. He actually said it was the worst tour in the world.
Oh shit!
Because you got to really wrangle the Australian audiences. You got to get them, and you got to like pull them in, and then they love you, but it takes a little bit of effort.
yeah. I think the Australian audience kind of brings it out. A part of our personalities. I think we become like somehow a lot goofier and
you can't be
in Byron Bay. What was it? And he shouted Wonderwall at us or something, and then I spent the next 2 minutes like rattling off how he doesn't deserve to live or something. something terrible, and the whole audience was applauding me and just like shunning him. It was so funny.
You've got to get him on your side. You see, you got to poke him, they'll yell at you, and you got to yell back at them, and then you're all right. Okay, you can't. You're not stuck up. All right. Okay, I'm cool with you now.
Depends. Like on the geography of the situation. Like we had South Australia was always just such a friendly and wholesome
place. They will behave there.
And then when we went like near the sort of like the coast, like the surface part, like and the Byron Bay kind of area, we're just like, we need to get out of here. It's scary up here. Everybody's either really, really muscly or wants to kill me.
Okay, I'm going to play a song. Mm-hmm. It's a newish one too. I didn't write much last year in lockdown, but this one came out sort of just, I guess you were just, I was thinking a lot about other mates in lockdown and also yourself trying to mentally handle it. And, I don't know. I suppose it's like a checking in on your friends kind of song, maybe. But you know, when you write a lyric and it's not exactly clear what you're saying, and after a while it becomes clearer. So it's one of those ones. It'll have inner meaning later on in life for me, I think. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I'll play it. Okay, see you in a second. See you in a second. Okay. I do have the lyrics there, but I'll just put them up on the screen so you think I'm just looking at you. I'll take these off. Fix the hair again. I went with the banjo number because it's in my hands. It does sound a little bit like the one, but not too much. doesn't sound like that. Anyway. I'll get it. There it is. Tell me how you feel. Tell me why you cry. What's going on? What is in your life? Tell me about your day. Sounds like where you are. All your friends are gone. All that's left feels dark. And I will give you hope. And I will hear you tonight. And I will send you sweet, sweet dreams to dream. When the rivers run, they don't even try. Climbing down the roots, flowing with the tide. I know we're confused. I pull off to the side, but the rain will come and we will be revived. And it will give us hope. And it will bring us to life. And it will take. Sweet, sweet rain to dream. Over us is God, under us is earth. Every day I learn, every day I heard. Ease is not the word, but simple is the way. We just have to stop trying to escape. We will plant it with life, and it will grow strong, sweet, sweet fruit to eat. Tell me how you feel, tell me why you cry, what is going on? Tell me where you are. Sounds like our friends are gone. All that's left is stars.
Woo! Mm-hmm. That was so beautiful.
Thank you.
Like honey.
Like honey. Ah, oh, nice. That's even with my little swipe. What did you say? I missed that. So
yeah, well, every single time you enter that chord, both Brandon and I are like, ooh,
ooh, the little the cheeky one. Yeah. Just sing. My friend's on the couch over there. So the girls are upstairs watching, and my friend is on the couch watching, and she gave me a little ooh at the end. That's nice. Thank you. Oh, look, it's like the Wexford crew are joining in. Hey, Sheila. Hey, cool. And, oh, yeah, we got and Martin Lay there. Thanks, Martin. And, oops, I didn't know how to press. What have I done? Oh, I always feel it. Okay. And then Sheila said hi. Yay. And Kayleen's, join in. Thanks, Claire. I did. I don't normally bring up my own comments, but I did just then because it's nice. Thank you. Thank you. So have you been home? Have you been back to Ireland at all recently?
Yeah, we were back for pretty like all of August, was it? We were back there around
3 weeks.
For the first time since even before our like 2020 Australian tour, so like December 2019,
yeah.
Was like we left to go kind of at New Year's, went over to Australia to do the tour, and then got like stuck in Australia with the lockdown, and then got the planes back to Germany, and then we were in lockdown in Germany up until Like, well, it kind of fluctuated, of course. Like, the summer was very short.
So they let you out. Australia let you out because they didn't let everybody out, did they?
Yeah,
they didn't really let Aussies back.
They really locked it in. It was like a. I think it was like a movie trying to.
It
get
was
out
lucky
of the
that
city.
We had like a confirmed German address.
Yeah,
that was like as we had, like. We were talking with the police and all, and also that we spoke a little bit of German.
Yeah. Because it was kind of like the one policeman who went to the other was like, do they speak German? Yeah, let them go.
Yeah, cool.
Like, that's a good. Thank God for Duolingo.
Yeah. So in Australia, they would have said, like, oh, you know, so do you know what cricket is or something like that? You know, and then he's like, yeah. And then you would have been okay. You know, you just got to get those little things that get you over the line.
Yeah. Right. So what do you do if your bed is burning?
Very good. All right. Cool. There you go. You've been queried on your German already.
I don't actually speak German. Speak German. We unlearned it.
Yeah.
what are you going to play for us now?
This is a German, traditional German song. we're going to sing a new song, which we released as a single like 2 months ago. And it's called Time We Need to Decide. And it's about playing games with people, but physically and metaphysically. I was playing Scrabble with someone once upon a time, and it wasn't working out. And
that's what happens when you play Scrabble and Monopoly. Yeah. Girls told me today that the Queen doesn't like Monopoly anymore because one of the children threw the board at her. So I don't know if that's real or not, but you know, that's a big thing. No one wants a board thrown at them.
Yeah. you make enemies of your best friends with board games.
Yeah. Okay, go forth, Ellis. Go.
1, 2.
Stakes. Is it fine to count my cards? I've only got jokers in my hands. And while we sit around the table talking with ourselves, can I stop all the noise inside my head? As we sit and listen to the rolling noise of cars on cobblestone, it's the time we need to take our different roads. And as we stop and talk about it with whatever cards we find, it's the time we decide. It's the time we need to decide. It's the time we need to decide. Gone wine. Is it right to say I'm fine? I thought the stone's throw is shorter when it's over my shoulder. I'm playing different games, but with all the cards the same, I thought of Joker in all his suit of hearts to tie me over. And as we sit and listen to the rolling noise of cars on cobblestone. It's the time we need to take our different roads. But as we stop and talk about with whatever cards we find, it's the time we need to decide. 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 It's the time we need to decide.
Woohoo! Ah, beautiful.
Wow. Thank you, Australia.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. There's like this loud from the crowd. That was like my version of a stadium.
We actually have stadium. A fellow Australian with us in the apartment. He's gone to the shop. Yeah.
Ah.
But Mr. Michael Brinkworth is
nice. Did you ever meet him?
No, I didn't. Or maybe I have. Is he going to sing a song too?
He's from the Brisbane way.
Yeah,
I think
cool.
I think he's gone to the shop. I don't know if he'll be back.
You never know.
I think Michael Brinkworth, he's in this breakfast state where it's kind of like Schrodinger's cat, where he's actually not alive, but he's not dead. it's just an intermittent breakfast space where Michael doesn't really exist. it's like a very intense version of like, don't talk to me before I've had my coffee, but it's like 4 hours long.
That's good. You know exactly what to do, you know. You don't play Monopoly with him, definitely.
What are you singing for us?
Well, I was going to sing, I just was thinking, I've got a new one. I wrote it because my friend was telling me a story about himself. And, you know, like how sometimes, I don't know, this was one of those days where I instantly sat down. I was like, man, I need to write a song in response to the story he just told me. And so this is like a super freshie, which is fun. Mm-hmm. But, I'll do that. Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. It's called, I don't think it has a name yet actually, but we'll call it My Friend, or no, we'll call it Water Lily actually. There you go. Oh, you got some claps. Look, there's your claps and your love hearts. Look at that. and your wunderbars and your amazing. Look at that. Lovely. First time. Okay. I'll see you in a second. I'll play this song and talk to you soon. Okay. I keep switching my head, take my head off. Okay. Is my hair all right?
I fancy beside me. Tell me something, even when it's bad. And we can go on, maybe we'll roam, kicking up the sand. Walk the back streets, back to your room. You pretend that I'm your water lily.
Oops.
Thank you.
she held me closely back when we were kids. Me, your one and only. It's good to see your face, see your laughing eyes. Talk to or me. I'm sorry, I actually don't know the damn chord. Talk to me and take me back in time. My friend sit beside me, even when you're sad. My friend tell me something, even when it's bad. We can go home, maybe we'll roam, kicking up the sand, walk the back street. You pretend that I'm your water lily. Oh my god, sorry. Oopsie daisy. That's right. It was out of sight, that chord.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played in that piece of Lord.
That's what I was keeping it secret, so that I was keep pleasing the Lord on my own. Oh,
Melanie,
no.
Do you like Caris Matthews or Cerise Matthews?
Cerise is from Wales?
Yeah.
Is she?
Yeah, she has this folk album. And it's amazing. It's like so good. But I always hear a bit of similarities in just the style of folkiness.
Oh,
I guess.
Cool. I remember. She was in a band. Was she?
Yeah.
She's. And I can't remember the song, but yeah, I remember
Roadway?
A bit. Yeah. I just remember singing it on repeat. Like, yeah. I loved it so much. So, yeah. Oh, I'll go and listen. That sounds cool. Yeah, I loved her voice. So that's great. Thank you. Yeah.
We want updates on the children. How are they doing? Are they like old and bitter now?
They're definitely old and bitter. Hang on. I'm just gonna yell up the staircase. 1 second.
We've been big fans of the Creative Kids Club.
Creative Kids Love Go. 1 second, ready? Yeah. I'm just gonna get them down. You guys, you just tell everybody a joke, and I'll be 1 second.
Yeah. So a man walks into a chip shop with a salmon under his arm, and this is a shite joke. A man walks into chip shop with a salmon under his arm, and he looks at the menu and he said, "By any chance, do you have any fish cakes?" And then the person says, "No, we don't. Sorry." And he said, "Oh, it's a shame. It's his birthday today." That's the joke.
Oh, cakes. Okay, yeah, cool. Hang on. I've got to hang on. Will you go over that side? Hop up. You go that way. Okay, one there, and then one over this side, and they're going to give you an update on how what it's like. Up down here, come on.
Life.
Ready?
Life.
I'm going to unplug the headphones so they can actually hear you, which means everything might echo, but it's okay. You know, we just got to deal with that. Mm-hmm. Hang on. Ready? Oh, no. Hang on. Oh, all these buttons. Ah! There you are. All right. They want an update on you too. Mm-hmm. How's your life been?
Discuss.
This one's a teenager, so this was like a bit cheeky, but I was trying to give her a birthday present of you two playing music. How good's that, right?
That's
a good friend.
Yeah. Is Harmony still writing poetry?
Are you still writing poetry?
No.
What?
No.
Oh. He's shy or something. You missed what they said before about they actually love following the creative kids' love go adventures. So the girls, for anybody watching, they have their own YouTube channel and they make videos. Are you embarrassed? Oh, no. They make videos and everything like that. So I think I'll tell them to back upstairs again.
I wish I was that productive when I was younger. All we did was like play PlayStation
and do drugs.
We didn't do drugs.
They kind of play a bit of, they don't have PlayStation, but they play Roblox, which is sort of, it does mute the productivity a little tiny bit, you see.
But I suppose it's building, that's kind of like Minecraft, isn't it, where you build stuff in a game.
And yeah, and you buy fancy clothes and stuff. Hang on. They're like, Mom, I've just bought this outfit and it's 20,000 some points or something or other. To get your 2,000 points, you've got to dance. And to dance, they just have to press like dunk, 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 dunk. Anyway, sing us a song.
We're going to sing one that Ashley wrote and also a new fresh one that could go horribly wrong. It's only a couple weeks. Mm-hmm. It's called Kick the Ball.
Kick the Ball.
It's about the game that was a game in school called Kick the Bottle, where the first years and the six, then the fresh people that were like little people that would come into the school, they would put a bottle in the middle of the hallway, and if you kicked it, the like sixth years, the older kids, got permission to beat the shit out of you, but the joke was to run as fast as you can.
I was the middle child in a family of four. When it got cold, we camped out in the living room floor, blocked the draft from the door. I'll always kick the bottle before I kick the bucket. But when the old dog up and died, seems I lucked it out of it. Ooh. And that's my mother cried for the loss of friend. We moved into town, tried hard to pay our rent, spent the summers in a three-man tent. Ooh, ooh, ooh. But I'll always kick the bottle before I kick the bucket. When the old dog up and died, seems I lucked it out of it. But it seems when I moved out, left my troubles in the old house, to leave some things behind, I was the exception to the rule, the trouble I had in school. But to run or choose to stay, they'll beat you in the hallways. To fight, to wait your turn, kick it over once in a while, try escape from the pile. But I'll always kick the bottle before I kick the bucket. But when the old dog up and died, seems I lucked it out it. But I'll always kick the bottle before I kick the bucket. But when the old dog up and died, seems I lucked it out it.
Beautiful. So did you say that's a new one?
Sorry?
Did you say that's a new one?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. You did it. Woo, great.
Yeah.
No, 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 no crazy chord things I like me.
No, well, there you go. No, there's, no, we kept the key changes for the...
We actually ran out of chords, had to go back to the bass.
Yeah, I remember I did a gig a long time ago, and my friend Ian Shedden was playing the drums, and he plays it with in the Saints. I'm echoing a bit. I'm just trying to work out where I'm coming from. One second, I'll just. What am I echoing from? Can I echo? Anyway, sorry, I'm just trying to work out why I'm echoing. Nope, no idea. That's okay. So Chris Bailey from the Saints came along to the show, and he said, he gave me a bit of advice after the show, and one of the pieces of the advice was like, Melanie, you need to use less chords. And I thought that was awesome. because the Saints is like, is a punk band, you know, classic,
yeah.
The one of the, you know, great punk bands. So I did take that advice after, and I, you know, practice writing with even just one or two chords. It's fun. You can actually, you know, fun what kind of songs you can come up with if you just write with one chord even, and
yeah,
it makes
sure.
Fantastic melodies, I reckon. Yeah,
some of the best songs are one or two chords. Yeah, I think it's nice to have a mix, you know. Like I always look at like Paul Simon's albums where he has songs that are just one, two chords, and then the next song is like has over 100 key changes.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
You need to try everything. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you know when you play the gig, if you change all your strings every song, it's a bit hardcore. But if at least do it every second song, yeah. That's a good idea. I was always going to do it.
I like having a song that's like just two chords all the way through, and then like there's a bridge, and it's the most complicated. Thing of all time. Yeah, it's so funny. Yeah.
Like what?
We need to write one, like with in the bridge.
My Sweet Lord, I think, is like, you know, the George Harrison song where it's like,
yeah,
it's so repetitive, and then there's two key changes, and it's just got crazy then. Well, it's still repetitive, but like the song's super complex, I think.
Yeah. Geez, that's a good, you know, it's a cracker. Hey, I wrote It's a Cracker on Instagram, and I got on Facebook or Instagram, one of them, you know, and I got like reported. But it's a cracker is a compliment. But obviously it's a cracker means something else somewhere else. Anyway.
It means something else somewhere else.
It does, does it?
Yeah.
What does
oh,
it
mean? Wow.
Like a cracker is like a derogatory name for a white person.
Is it? Oh, I didn't know. No. There you go. Whereas we say it's like it's a cracker means, I guess it means probably like a firecracker. Like, something
yeah,
awesome.
I would say that as well.
Yeah, no, I would say that as well.
Yeah.
Funny, huh?
Well, we're from somewhere else.
We're from the other
Yeah,
place.
yeah. The other place. Well, I was gonna sing I almost for a second then was gonna sing Kathy's song. Which
Oh.
is Simon and Garfunkel. But I wasn't gonna play that version, I was gonna play and I always forget her name, it's terrible. She's Canadian. Oh. Someone's gonna pipe in and give me her
You want to
name.
mention?
No, she's
No.
so this it oh no. No.
She
It's
does a version of Kathy's
it,
song.
she does a version of Kathy's song and she loses her she keeps sticks to just a few of the verses. And so Cassidy, Eva Cassidy. And so it has a whole other meaning because of her life and she died quite young from cancer and she just had these most beautiful recordings of her playing lots of great songs, lots of covers, and they all sort of took off after she'd died. So sad and happy at the same time. But yeah, she has a lovely voice, and so maybe I will. Shall I play that? Since I'll play that version of Kathy's song. All right, I was
It's
going
the
to play something
same
else. I was
just with less verses, and it makes more
less
sense.
verses. It makes more
Right.
sense to it's sort of less. Songwritery and more yeah, it makes sense, to her life and it's nice to sing, so I'll play that. Okay. All right. See you in a second.
In a sec.
Okay. Oh, there I am. Kayleen was gonna say Shania Twain. Not Shania Twain, but I do like Shania Twain.
gorgeous.
That was beautiful. Mm-hmm. I love that song so much.
Mm-hmm.
Me too. Yeah, like you just want to sort of sit there, sing it on repeat. It's so pretty, right?
Yeah. It could be 15 minutes long, and it would be perfect. So.
Mm. It's funny. It is raining here. Actually, I've got the fire on. Would you believe it? It's very strange, considering it's spring. But anyway, and it's such a beautiful drizzly. I mean, I suppose you're used to it in Ireland, but it's the lovely grey, like you said about the mist, you know, or the fog, that lovely grey drizzliness. Mm-hmm. You know exactly what kind of day it is that you'd write a song like that.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
What song you got for us?
Which song do we have for us?
My as well come. My new one.
I can't.
Yeah.
That's too hard. Let's do... Let's... Oh, I got one. All right. And we're gonna do. I can't sing that. But this one will be good. We're gonna sing a song called "Our Way Out of This." And this one I wrote about 2 years ago. And what's it about? I don't know. It's about. Do you have a couple?
Libraries.
No, I don't. About a few things. My wish to be to work at a library and tell people to shush. And also. kissing someone with a nose ring. It's about that as well.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
You don't have a couple, I have one in my pocket. Alright.
It's funny, I lost my capo before too. I was trying to very subtly kind of make my way around the room looking for the capo.
And when everything's set up around you and there's so much that can go wrong, it's just...
Yeah.
You don't want to move.
Yeah.
Out of your nose, just a kiss.
no way of knowing. Drunks in the town are broken. Write it all down. I know them. The drunks in the town are broken. You took the ring out of your nose just to kiss. I took the time to pretend I exist. There's no way of knowing our way out of this. There's no way of knowing.
Thank you. Okay, we got some of this. A round of applause coming out. That is so pretty, man. You've got super fan here, cute to boot. There you go. Look at that.
Cute to boot.
Yeah, Andrew said love this.
I've never heard that phrase before.
Lots of applause there. Oh man, it sounds so beautiful. It sounds so good, and it's so cool too, because you're never entirely sure if it, you know, how's it going to sound down the line on a stream and stuff like that, and it just comes across so nice. It's gorgeous. Cool.
I was thinking
before, you know, giving some background as to why Gypsy and Harmony are your super fans. Because we played, just telling everybody that we played together at Smith's in Canberra. And as usual, I had my girls there, and they just, you know, they loved the music, but they also thought you two were fun. And you were both so awesome, because even though they sort of like grabbed you and dragged you around everywhere, they were a bit smaller, so they climbed, you know, climbed and sat on you and hugged you and told you about the piano and you know, like, told you everything about yourselves and, you know, cool people are the kinds of people who make them feel, he made me feel heaps comfy and cool and that you made them happy, and that's right. That's good. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, they're like, you three were the coolest people at the bar. We were like, we're finally someone at our level.
And they're such, such a cool kid.
You said really brilliant conversations. Like, I was just sitting there quietly, you know, observing. Just, it's so nice watching, you know, as a mum, like watching them interact with people and have conversations and, you know, oh yeah, it's just cool. It's cool. Thank you. I was gonna play. I thought of, you know, I'm following up on the rain. I've got no nose ring songs, but I I could continue the rain theme, and I might go there. It's a song called North Sea that I wrote, you know, on a rainy day when I was living in the caravan on the block, as opposed to inside of the house, which is not too dissimilar to, it's just like a gigantic caravan. There's sort of holes in it, and there's lots and lots of spider webs. And apparently there are these birds that can fly in your house and eat the spiders, which that sounds really useful. But I like the spiders because they eat the flies.
Cats eat spiders, no?
Do cats eat spiders? I don't. My cat doesn't eat spiders.
Depends on the cat, I think.
Yeah. And the spider.
And the spider.
And how hungry they are. Yeah, because there's a few spiders that cats don't really want to eat, eh?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, there's a few spiders that eat the cat.
Yeah. So did your flatmate return in a human state, or he still looks a bit?
I haven't heard like any sort of noises of people coming in.
I think they're probably lost in the supermarket.
Yeah, I can have a look. Maybe I can get Michael
on. But it's funny. When I went to Leipzig actually last time I was there, I was looking for entertainment, and I actually went into supermarkets and just looked at the products because I thought it was so interesting.
The crazy thing when you're in another country to go to the supermarket.
Mm. Yeah, like the cereals are just the, you know, just if you just do cereal aisle, I mean, it's already wacky. Yeah.
But trying to find the eggs in Germany is because the thing is, there's never, like, depending on the supermarket, there's not really a place for the eggs in Germany. But, like, and they're just like in a different place every day. They're just like, we'll put them here. And yeah, it's like a national joke of like, where are the eggs going to be this time? And people just looking around for eggs. Yeah. Like life, I suppose, you know?
It's like, I'm sure they know where the sausages are. They're like, I swear you'd probably know where the pork knuckle is and the sausages. And then, like, I loved being in Germany, how, like, you've got, like, full-on meat eaters and full-on vegans all in the same area. So,
true, yeah.
Are you on the vegan or, I mean, you probably, maybe you're, like, just a bit of both because...
We're veggies, so, you know, veggies, yeah.
Yeah, we're in the middle, Dad. We're veggies.
In the middle. You still eat the eggs. That's good.
Eggs
are a marvelous thing. Like, don't laugh, but I've got two chickens and a rooster, and they live in my bathroom. And I've been thinking, I wonder where they've been putting the eggs, because they hide them. And I just found where the eggs are, and it's like, you know, it's a magical thing that you can go outside and get some dinner.
How big is your bathroom?
It's pretty big. It's like a 10 square meter bathroom outside, it's like a shed outside. But they decided that they'd move out of their chicken house and that they would live on top of the door of the bathroom instead. So they go into the bathroom in the afternoon and they fly up 2 meters and sleep on top of the bathroom door.
Do they wake you up in the morning? Are they also an alarm clock as well as the food supply?
Well, because it's in the bathroom, the rooster, I think the rooster thinks he is the biggest rooster in the universe, because when he crows, it echoes off all the tiles. So he's like, I am a man. I am the man.
I hope there's magazines in the bathroom that they read.
Oh, they're pretty fun. And so if you go to the bathroom in the middle of the night, you hear this.
Are you sure that's the chickens?
Yes, it's the chickens. It's the rooster. He's just checking on. I'm like, it's just me, man. It's just me. It's fine. I'm not going to get eaten. Everything's good. I'll play you the song North Sea. Okay, I'll stop talking about the chickens. Okay, see you in a second. Okay. Very high spot, which is kind of annoying. Bugger. Sorry, I'm going to move it down one because it's not going to behave there, and that's a bit awful. Nothing demanding in this weather. The drip, 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 caravan roof. The candlelight and grey skies are twins in affection. And the old book rests on my lap. There's no need for reading, just hands on the cover. Dances inside, reviewing November.
watercolor city on last year's calendar. The pleasure of thoughts rolling in. The North Sea is icy, dark blue, white tipped, deep water, ancient. I lit the candles at the corner of sunset. The trees in the west protect me from glare. It's just a ghost sky between high fives and dusk. Maybe summer is taking a rest. I tap myself down on the covers. The patterns of roses provide me a home. I won't reach for anything other. The sleep is relieving and calm. Pacific is warm, renewed, volcanic, clear water.
What was that about?
It's about, it was a feeling song, like I was feeling a bit strange that day, and I suppose there's a romance involved, and I don't know. Isn't that funny? Like, I just like, once again, it's that feeling thing of like, you could sit there playing it for ages, and I like the melody, and I like the ideas of like the North Sea being deep and dark and cold, and then, you know, the Pacific, the clear, warm,
mm-hmm.
and young, but I don't know exactly what it's about. I just like it.
Yeah.
it's like it can mean so many things to different people. That's nice imagery. Yeah. Mm. And just that idea of a feeling, you know, when I write songs, I have a tendency to try and, if I start on a chord or I start on a note, I don't let myself change the key until I've completed it. And so, you know, you're trying to explain this overwhelming feeling inside of whether things are going to work or not going to work or whatever. And it's raining and you're in a caravan and, you know, trust or et cetera. Yeah, and so it's kind of funny to just use images and melody mm-hmm. without actually saying exactly what was going on, because you don't really know. You don't know. You still don't know what's going on. Like, does he like me? I don't know. Talk about the sea instead.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
Have you got another song for us?
Yeah, we can do. We can do one more for the road.
Yeah, if you do one for the road, that'd be cool. We've talked a lot. I mean, you can do two more for the road if you like to, because I'm sure a bunch of people have tuned in to hear your song. So if you want to give us two, that'd be cool. And you know, you probably got to go about your day now because it's daytime.
Yeah. We'll catch up with you at some point in the future. It'll be 9 p.m. for us soon, is what I meant.
Yeah.
I'd really love to try a new one, the new one. Do you think you're warmed up for that? I don't think I am, but I'd like to sing it anyway. I can do it in falsetto. Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna try a new one that I wrote. That it's called Landlords, and I don't know if you've seen that there's a big uprising at the moment because the in Dublin at the moment they're trying to get all of the there's one of the main Irish music venues being turned into a hotel.
And Cobblestones, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, and it's just really depressing and sad because it's just Dublin's becoming more of a unlivable city than it ever was, you know. And it's,
yeah.
I mean, there's always been a lot of struggle there to live. We've tried and failed to live there and just be musicians, you know.
Yeah, that's kind of the reason why we're in Leipzig, because we couldn't live in Dublin. So.
Yeah. When I go over there, I have a tendency to stay in Drogheda.
And
it's funny because I get to, you know, you get teased sometimes if you say where do you stay, and I think they want you to say Dublin or they want you to say Cork or something, and I'm like, it's Drogheda, and they're like, why Drogheda? But like I said, it's more, you know, livability. I think that maybe it's a little more livable, really. And it's got, you know, these great little venues and stuff. So when all the tourists and all the big companies take over our spaces, we have to sort of move out into the land. Yeah. You know, I live 500 km from Sydney, so you know.
Yeah. Drogheda is only like 50 km from Dublin.
Yeah, not that far.
Yeah, it's emotionally far though, I think.
Yeah, it's
an emotional distance.
The concept of like location in Ireland, people wouldn't go 20 minutes to a place. If there was a gig on 20 minutes away, they'd be like, it's too far. While in Australia, it was really like, oh, it's only 2 hours away. Oh, yeah, we're there. You know.
Yeah, yeah. Cool. Yeah. Sing us a song. I'll put you something. Yeah. Here.
Oh yeah, how does it start?
Falling side by side.
That's cool. Hang on, I'm just going to clap. I had to turn the thing off again. Wow, it's beautiful. Oh, here you go. You got a dog put in there.
The banner.
Oh.
He's right. We're truly, truly awful at playing hurling.
Oh.
Are you?
We've been practicing playing table ping pong, so hopefully our skills have developed into another stick sport.
Mm. Stick and ball sport.
Maybe. Need to practice.
Well, yes. Do you want to play us one more? And my semi image saying, you're breaking up, but the fillers are fine. So I won't try and sing because apparently I must sound a bit peculiar, but I'd love to hear another one from you. All the Aussie crew want, like, are just giving you like a massive, you know, what do you call it? Encore right now. Woo, play us another one.
Well, I think we're going to do a new song, and this is a song I wrote. I was reading, I started reading a William Faulkner book called The Sound and the Fury, and which is just the most crazy, depressing book that I've ever read. And the first chapter is in the perspective of a mentally disabled 30-year-old man and how he perceives the world. But how it's written is so intensely creative, because his take on perspective and the perspective of how he sees like his depth perception and just like the imagery of what's around him is just he captures it really well, that like because he doesn't understand basic concepts, he sees more in a way, because he's not. Yep. So it's kind of about that.
Oh my God.
You've got a bit of more coming up there, look. Okay. Cool. All right.
There's a fire within you, a fire in the mirror, a shadow that's shorter than mine. There's leaves with the shadow, the tree with the light. You can only see if you're blind. And you get used to what you're seeing, you don't care about the sight. When you look on bright side, the dark sits to your right. 'Cause I've lost faith, and you've lost feeling, and the light is the cover, the shadow's the real thing, the shadow's the justify the anger and nullify the sound. The sweet rhododendrons ignite. And there's a pleasure in the longing, so don't ever come around. There's a sweet satisfaction in flight. When you get used to who you're seeing, you don't care about their sight. But when you look on the bright side, the dark sits to your right. 'Cause I've lost faith, and you've lost the feeling, and the light is the cover, the shadow's the real thing, the shadow's the thank you.
It's a fire within you, a fire in the mirror, and both will extinguish in time.
Thank you.
I give you that so you know I'm there. That little woohoo over the line. Ah, so beautiful. Man, I'm gonna look forward to putting your record on later. So I put a link up above for anybody watching to your website. And is anything else you wanna mention? Like, do you have a tip jar, or I mean you just all should just buy their music, but otherwise, there's a tip. Do you have a tip jar or something like that, or a Patreon or anything like that?
We have a Patreon for sure. Yeah, Patreon.
Awesome. PayPal.
Yeah, we have. So our Patreon is just patreon.com/theocelots, I think. And yeah, if you do want to just subscribe, we put up all of our unreleased songs there, and blogs, and all exclusive content. And we'd love to get more people involved.
The CDs you can get on
theocelots.com. We have a merch site there. You can buy CDs at theocelots.com. You'll find everything you need. And then what else do we have? What's that? paypal.me/theocelotsmusic. Maybe we can type it in comments.
We have the board. No.
It's backwards.
Yeah, I know. It is. It
but
is
if,
backwards.
If you've got...
No, it's at the street.
Tell me the site and just type it in now. What's the paypal.com/
theocelotsmusic.
No, it's not paypal.com. It's paypal.me. No.
paypal.me/theocelotsmusic.
So Ocelots Music. I'll just put that there. But otherwise, I've put your website at the top, and and that's cool. And there you go.
Thanks so much for having us. It was such a blast. So good to see you guys again.
Yeah.
Hopefully we can see each other in the flesh soon.
Yeah. I'll see. I can't wait to, I can wait, but because you want to be safe and everything, but I look forward to hopping on the road and singing and traveling, because I'm, you know, you miss all these beautiful people that you meet and the interactions you have with them. So we can say goodnight. I can still say goodnight to you after we log off, but we can say goodnight, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Thank you. We can come back and reply to your comments later, and see you next week. Next week I've got a super cool secret lady, and it's going to be Canadian time, so I'm going to do the daytime person next week, nice. Actually, because Canada time is way too hardcore. So that'll be I think for me next week it's going to be like, I think it's 10 a.m. on Saturday. So just warning everybody, next week in Australia it's going to be a daytime concert. Thanks everybody. Good night.
Yeah, happy birthday. Yeah, again.
Oh yeah. Yes.
We'll hopefully see you soon. Have a good end of the night.
Yeah, and keep in touch.
Thank you.
Bye. See you guys. Let me see.